Plastic welding is a fantastic way to repair damaged and cracked fuel tanks. In today's short video, I'm going to show you just how easy it is to do for free without any specialist tools. If I wanted to replace the fuel tank on this Briggs and Stratton, it's going to be over $100 just in parts, 2 or 3 weeks wait, plus then time to actually fit it. And being that this is for a commercial customer, it's just not something that we can do. If you've got an old screwdriver and a means of being able to heat it up, you can plastic weld your fuel tanks within a few minutes. So it's just a T27 we need for this process, and there's two of those screws. And then we have a catch here at the front. So we'll pop this plastic cover off. I find the best method is to get a screwdriver in there, prise it back, and then it'll come up and out. And then it's really simple, we just prise up on the fuel tank and we just disconnect the fuel hose. Well, I actually thought it was coming out of here, but looking closely, you can see that there's actually damage slightly to the side there. So I've got here a hand pump. Now you can use whatever you've got, air compressor, foot pump, it doesn't matter. And of course, some soapy water. So let's pressurize this fuel tank and we'll see whereabouts the leak is for certain. Of course, we know, or we think we know, we've got one here. And that is the only one that I can currently see, because it also looks like there's some gnawing marks here and around here as well. So it could very well have been a rodent that has bitten into this. The key with any sort of repair is to make sure the surfaces are really well cleaned. And I'm just using a little bit of brake cleaner here. You can use alcohol. And I'm going to use a Stanley quick clamp here, and it's just going to free up both of my hands. And the hole we need is right there. And I mentioned earlier about a screwdriver. I've actually bent the tip on this one, and that's just going to make smudging that plastic back down much easier. And it's going to help to avoid you puncturing through that tank when the tip of the screwdriver is nice and hot. And of course, it's just as important to clean the screwdriver, because if there's any rust or there's any oils or there's any old plastic from a different type, you'll find that it won't seal that joint very well. Or you might find that it will quickly fail because it's not actually adhered itself to the plastic. So we'll first heat up the screwdriver. And don't go for too long. You don't want it to be bright orange because you're just going to go straight through that tank. But nice and warm is what we're looking for. I'm going to create just a bit of a valley where that damage is. I really want to get under the damage. I don't want to just smear over the top. As you can see, we've made that valley. We haven't punctured through the tank. If you've got a very thin tank, it can be easy to puncture through. And what that valley has achieved is it's actually melted the hole that's gone through the tank. I'm not just covering over the surface that could then crack again really easily. I've melted that whole section. And now we'll reheat the screwdriver. We're going to press that plastic on the outside back in and smooth it back off. Get that plastic to go in. There. And on the bottom, like so. So we've really filled that back up. And now all that's left to do is to clean it up and make it look nice and smart. We get it nice and level. And with that, we need a much cooler tip to our screwdriver. So just warm. And I'm going to use the plastic around it to smooth it and level it back up. You can see how much cooler the screwdriver is. And this way, we haven't just smeared over the top and left that damaged hole all the way through the tank. We've physically sealed the whole thing back up. There are a few little tooth marks around here. I don't think it's necessary to worry about going over those. They're incredibly shallow. So let's now repressurize this tank and see if that's fixed it. Now we'll pump it up. Nothing coming out at all. And of course, the moment of truth, is it going to leak?
Perfect.
Have you ever wanted to see what it looks like inside an engine when it's running? I've got this video up here, which is exactly that. I made a see-through spark plug. I hope you enjoy that video. And until next time, I'll catch you soon.